Shower room. Okay. Oi. I do not like these wall things. They're really annoying. There's the room. So this is the shower room. Water's dripping now, that's new. Wow, we can really get moving around here. That's awesome. Yeah, his was right there. There's literally nothing from him? That sucks. Yep. Weird. Alright, I think the time has come to go to the third floor. Whoop. Almost fell off there. That would not be good. What am I doing? Oh, you can't fall off. That's good to know. Well, let's see. Because it definitely is open. Is there more that I can do with this? No. Oh, I was on the third floor. I've got where the water's flowing now. Maybe it's a rotation thing. It is a rotation thing. I have to rotate it so that the pipes work. Wow, this is really complex. But I don't see what everyone's complaining about. Cause I've heard, wow, the water prison, it just freaking sucks, man. And it's like, this isn't bad. I think it's up, actually. Okay. I should have gone and looked at the second floor. We're just gonna have to eyeball it. No, idiot. Turn it right. All the pipes are going. Well, hey! It does show up. Awesome. So we'll need to rotate the other one left once. Yep. I don't mind this at all. This is actually fine. And now I don't have to deal with the side hackers there. I'm very happy. Very happy about this. Wait a minute. We have to rotate it so it orients with the floor one. It's not gonna be on otherwise. I went past the door. No, I didn't. I would have to go past the ladder first. Alrighty. I've got this. I know what I'm doing. So, we're on the first floor. We go up. What we're going to do now is we're going to rotate it in the orientation so that it works. Oh, okay, forget it for now. So right now it's working. But on floor one, we have one that's leaking. We can't rotate floor one. So we need to rotate floor two so that it matches up. So it needs to go left twice, I think. But once we get the water going that way, we'll be fine. So then upstairs needs to go left twice. Okay, so now floor one is getting all its water. So we should have the water wheel on now. Yeah, I don't know what anyone's complaining about. This is fine. This is actually really interesting. And it's actually built really well. Which definitely helps. There it is. The beautiful sounds of water. Water's not going in the right direction for some reason. Is it because it's hitting both of them? Was I right before? No, because we came down. Well. No, I didn't come down here. It's literally because. Yeah. That's aggravating. So we need to make it so that the water only hits one side, and it needs to hit the correct side. So that the water wheel goes in the correct direction to start the engine. Okay. So it needs to only hit one of those corners. The other two are fine. It needs to hit one of those corners. That's all we need to do. We're going to turn it right once. This should, right here, solve our entire problem. Or no, it should have been left once. Or not. We need to rotate it right twice. That's that. It's currently not hitting anything. But if I turn it one more time, it should hit it. Okay. Now, from here, it'll only hit those two. In the basement, it'll only hit one side. We should be good now. Because the wheel was stalling out because it was hitting both sides. Now it's hitting one side. And hopefully, this is the side that is correct. We have water, ladies and gentlemen. We have a turning wheel. We have a spinning engine. So now the lights are on. On the third floor. Man, this is crazy. Alrighty. Nice and easy. Going up to the third floor. Because this is where we get to see where the lights are. I got lights. It doesn't show me where the lights are on the map. Oh, is it because the lights are everywhere? The lights are everywhere. Okay. I need to remember what I'm doing. So, to get to the surveillance rooms, I bet you're just dying to see the interrogation room behind the kitchen. I understand your feelings, but have you noticed? There are three rooms with bloody beds. One is on the first floor, one is on the second floor, and one is on the third floor. If you line those three rooms up, then it's bingo. To light up the first and second floors, use the corpse disposal chutes. Since each floor of this building can be rotated, you can match up any of the cells by matching up the holes. Repeating this periodically is an effective way to keep the kids fearful. If you turn the handle in the middle of this room, you can easily rotate the cells. You can't rotate the first floor, so align the second and third with the first floor cell so that... Okay. I'm rotating bloodstained beds. So I don't care about any of that crap. I just want bloodstained beds. Bloodstained bed, right there. So it's right here. That is the bloodstained bed. So now I need to make sure that it lines up on the third floor. Well, let's go down to the first floor and see if we can line it up. Not lined up right now. That's a bloody bed. So the bloody beds need to be up on the top left. Or up on the top right, I mean. They need to be right here. Come on. It's currently right here. So I need to rotate it three times to the right. Alrighty. So it needs to be in this one. I'm wrong. We've got to find it. Okay. So I need one more rotation right. Okay. Now those two are matched. And you find the room up here with the bloody bed. That bed, she is bloody. One more. And I've still got water running. Bloody bed. They're all matched with the lights on. Let's roll. Because you remember they said, oh, it's too dark down there. I couldn't go in. If we light it, it's no longer too dark. What am I doing? Before we go in there, because I bet you there's going to be something big. Alrighty. Hello. He's like, I am staring at the door. All righty. She's not in the room. All righty. You know what? Just in case. No, that's not what I meant. Just in case, I'm going to take that other 10 bullets. So far, I haven't really fought any bosses, so, you know. I don't know.